Today on Florida Sport Fishing.
Okay.
Dude, look at the stripes on that thing. Look at the colors. Oh, nice job.
Pretty fish. This one hit the long rigger, crushed it.
Dolphin fishing, baby. Get you some.
Ho ho, what on?
CB Boats presents Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler. Powered by Mercury Marine.
Oh, got one on. There's a sailfish, already got a bite. Ridiculous.
Another one on.
That's what it's all about right there.
Yeah. Oh, look at that.
Florida Sport Fishing TV utilizes and proudly endorses Ghost, the global leader in boat security, monitoring, tracking, and surveillance. Motor Guide, the most dependable trolling motors on the water. VMC, tired of missed strikes? Fish the hooks the pros fish. Fish VMC. Rugged Shark, technical footwear designed for angling and boating enthusiasts. Ocean LED, for quality, high-performance underwater lighting, turn to Ocean LED.
Hey guys, welcome to Florida Sport Fishing TV. We're aboard our CB370Z. It's early June, and what better to do than to come out and look for some dolphin. We just, right now, set up about 10, 12 miles off. We're off of Boca, right on the edge of the Gulf Stream. Stumbled across a pretty decent weed line here. Not any real big patches yet, but a lot of scattered stuff. I do see some bait under the weed. So gonna keep working this edge here and see if we can find them. We've got a deep bait down on a planer. Of course, some Ballyhoo Islander combos, some lures in the spread. See if we can find these things, hook up, maybe throw some chunks. That's always a ton of fun. And I'll tell you, just an absolutely gorgeous morning. Early June, just a little bit of a breeze, 5 to 10. Blue skies, it's almost too nice, especially with this full moon. You know, that full moon is not exactly, doesn't really set the stage for an ideal dolphin trip, but like I always say, fish when you can fish, and we can fish today. Sure?
Yeah. Yeah, on the deep rod, right away.
He's not that small, huh?
No,
he ain't that little.
10 pounds.
Ready?
Yep. There you go.
Get him in! Nice. Yeah.
Nice job, Carlos.
Right away, man.
On the deep bait, huh? Dude, look at the stripes on that thing. Look at the colors.
Some good eating right there.
Look at the speed.
Yeah.
That thing must have probably come from a mile away just to attack that little bit.
Yeah, man. Ate that strip bait on that planer like it was nothing. Awesome. Get him on ice. Let's get the spread back out. So trying something a little different here. We brought in all of the lures, all of the baits, throw in a steady slick of chunks, just some cut up baits. And rather than trying to find them, see if we can bring them to us. A couple of frigates right here, great indicators of life below. Remember, those frigates can't get their wings wet. They wait for that bait fish to come up toward the surface. They wait for the dolphin and whatever game fish to push that bait up. And then they just swoop down and crush it. Really, really awesome.
Here they come. I see them.
I got the chunks. You worry about the fish. Nice little schoolies on little spinners. It's gonna be a ton of fun. Look at them all over the boat. Oh, I'm hooked up. Hooked up on a little peanut. There he is. Calm down, pal, I'm gonna let you go.
Last day of school. They all wanna go to recess.
Little shrimp, one of my favorites for throwing at schoolie dolphin. And just a little light spinner. See how long this takes. Oh! Was that instant or what?
You're on, Mike.
Absolutely. Whoa, watch it. He spit the shrimp. Awesome, just seeing all these little schoolies. I mean, this is what dolphin fishing's all about. Of course, I wish they were all 20 pounds, but you know, you can't always pick the size, that's for sure. That little dinky dink.
Dinky dink?
The Diggy Dink is barely hooked.
I'm gonna gaff that thing. It's like a pound.
Stop it. Bigger than the other one I caught. Don't lose him.
Oh yeah, because don't you even lose around him. The boat. Look at them all.
Yeah. Well, no, this is, come on, man. I caught him on an artificial. Anytime you catch one on an artificial, it's a,
you know what?
It's
that's
a, it's a prize. Are you
that's
kidding
that's 100% me? 100% true. A type of lure.
Those live target, scaled sardine.
They love those things.
Yeah,
man.
They kill them. It looks like a little pilchard.
When we come out dolphin fishing, we always bring a wide variety of tackle, a wide class of tackle, everything from the 30-pound class trolling outfits to these light little, you know, I guess we'll call them redfish rods. Not every time that you come out, you're gonna find those big gaffers that you're looking for. Sometimes it's just gonna be these little, you know, peanuts. So to maximize the fun factor, scale down. 10-pound braid, little chunk bait. This is what dolphin fishing's all about. It's just coming out, having a good time, catching these fish on the right tackle. They're all around the boat. There we go.
The award-winning Z Performance line from CV raises the bar. It's not just fast. It's not just fuel efficient. The CVZ is the entire package. It offers the perfect balance, safe, predictable handling during hard turns and at high speed. And most importantly, the Z stays on plane at lower speed so it can comfortably handle anything Mother Nature can dish out. Experience the exhilarating ride of the CVZ. Schedule a sea trial today.
It's your turn to score big. Book a long-range adventure aboard the legendary Yankee Captains. Fish virgin waters more than 100 miles offshore for exotic queen snapper, trophy tilefish, monster grouper, and more. With a lifetime of experience, let Captain Greg Mercurio and his dedicated crew put you on a hot bite. Fish around the clock or just relax. With full galley and huge fish boxes, all you'll need to bring is your appetite for action. Now sailing from Key West year-round.
Chaos is tragic. Chaos can be awesome.
Yo, another one on, another one on! Three on, baby!
With Chaos Fishing, it's your rod your way. Quality components and personalized service from a legendary builder equal the right rod at the right price every time. Shop online for a complete selection of serious fishing equipment. Or visit Chaos's new superstore and receive a free t-shirt with every rod purchase. Chaos Fishing, gear matters.
The Bubba Blade makes filleting fish faster, easier, and safer. Check this out. The Bubba Blade is super sharp and has a super grip.
You can feel everything with this knife. It's really nice.
The Bubba Blade is the only fillet knife you're ever going to need. So check out our website, BubbaBlade.com, and order your Bubba Blade today.
Hey guys, welcome back to Florida Sport Fishing TV. We're back on the troll here. We're out doing a little running and gunning this morning, looking for dolphin. Just stumbled across really just a big school of schoolies. We had a ton of fun catching them on really light tackle. But I think we got our fill. So we're getting back on the troll here, cruising up this weed line, seeing if we can find a couple of bigger fish. But that's really what it's all about, you know, putting in your time, focusing on the different forms of structure. We had some frigates before that we were kind of working with. And again, now this scattered weed here, with some decent patches right up here. It was absolutely loaded in those little 2 to 4 pound schoolies, which again, certainly that's nothing to brag about, but it's a lot of fun. I mean, that's what dolphin fishing is all about. It's about catching fish, bent rods, a couple of tasty blackened dolphin sandwiches for dinner. So we'll see if we can find a couple of gaffers here. That would really be nice. In them again, baby! Look at them all. Look at them all.
Yeah, there's a whole bunch up there.
Look at the life. That's just incredible. These little schooly dolphins are surrounded by all of these jacks. And we did the same thing. We came up on another big weed patch, started throwing the chunks. These fish are, for whatever reason, are not hitting our troll baits. I mean, probably because they're only about 20 inches. Wow, did you see that?
He tried to jump in the boat.
That was crazy. But on this light gear, so much fun. Look at them all right here. Whole school of them. Absolutely awesome. Come on, I'm gonna let you go, sweetie. twitch bait right there. Throw that out. Just work it really, really erratically like that. Dude, that take was great.
He came right up on that and destroyed it.
Absolutely crushed it.
Woo! Wow! Control your fish.
Dude, what a jumper. Bent rods, light tackle, schoolie dolphins. Gotta love it. You know, you can go dolphin fishing, but you can't always pick the size of the fish that you want. So it's a good idea to make the most out of whatever you come across. Hey, that's a pompano dolphin.
Got a pompano dolphin?
Yep, look at that. That's a pompano dolphin. See the different shape in that head and how that whole body is more rounded? Very hard to distinguish the two, but you can clearly see that that looks a little odd from a regular dolphin. That's what you call a pompano dolphin. Really, really cool. Tend not to see these pompano dolphin get very large. You only see these little ones like this. Almost has a head like a pompano as well. See you later. Sweet.
Pro's Tip, presented by Pelagic High Performance Offshore Gear, official apparel of Florida Sport Fishing TV.
You know, we're trolling along out here, really right along these weed lines. There's some nice patches, but it reminds me of a question that I'm often asked, which is, what's the proper trolling speed? You know, where do I troll at? 6 knots, 8 knots, 10 knots? And you know, the truth is, there is no one perfect trolling speed. It really depends. It depends on the conditions. It depends on if you're pulling artificial lures or natural baits or a combination of the both. Are you going down sea or up sea with the current, against the current? There's a lot of different variables. Really, the best answer I can give you is the right trolling speed is when your baits are tracking properly. When you look back in the spread and everything just looks perfect, you know, smoking just below the surface, coming up to gulp air, you know, and just take a breath. That's what we call that with those lures, and then dissipates all that smoke. And sometimes that's 6 knots and sometimes it's 10 knots. Also depends on the target species. You know, if we're targeting yellowfin tuna, blackfin tuna, you know, any of those sorts of tuna species, you want to increase your speed, that's for sure. On the other hand, if you're pulling all naked ballyhoo, slow it down. 4 knots, 5, 6 knots is really all that you need to do. So again, it's really a combination of a lot of different factors that are going to determine exactly what that perfect trolling speed really is.
And when it comes to dolphin fishing, it's really important to get out here nice and early and get an early start. You know, the early bird gets the worm is really true in this case. You know, the water temperatures start to come up in the middle of the day, and when the water gets warmer, the fish tend to shut off, you know. So you need to get out here nice and early, get a head start. You really want to try and get your lines in the water. As the sun's coming up, you're going to have a better chance to consistently catch more fish.
Mercury engine test.
Lightest 115 horsepower in its class. It's good to have Mercury behind you.
When you want to get away from it all, to a place where you can do everything, or nothing at all, surrounded by natural beauty and all the modern amenities you might desire, then you'll want to be here, at the Wannabe Inn, on the beautiful shores of Manasota Key, Florida. To plan your escape, log on to wannabein.com.
What if navigating was as simple as touch and go? It is that simple. The world's first multi-touch MFT chart plotter, Navmint TZ Touch.
Mercury engine test.
Fuel efficiency you can rely on. It's good to have Mercury behind you.
Always got to be ready with a bucket of chunks, some squid, some silver sides. Just something ready to throw, you know.
We always carry
a bunch of silver sides from Bionic Bait. Yeah, that's a decent one. Just in case his buddies are swimming with him.
Hold on. Got him.
Nice. Dude, fatty.
Nice dolphin.
That's what we're looking for right there.
Pretty fish. This one hit the long rigger, crushed it. Sick looking fins. You can see the purple and blue on his pec fins there. Amazing color. That's why these fish are so heavily targeted. But they do grow quick, and there's plenty of them out there. You just gotta leave the dock and go get them.
Tasty. A little Florida Sport Fishing seasoning.
Baked or grilled, can't go wrong.
Fried works too.
Yeah.
Oh, nice jump. Coming together, boys. Coming together.
Stickage.
Nice. Woo!
Here we go, baby. South Florida dolphin.
Every now and then you see them with their fins tore up like that too. That could be a bill swipe from a marlin or something. You never know.
My favorite fish to catch, man.
Very pretty fish. Matching your shorts.
Yeah, man. Look at that.
Rigging Station, presented by Diamond Fishing Products, makers of the finest monofilament and braided fishing line in the world.
Hi, and welcome to this episode's Rigging Station. Dolphin fishing is an absolutely ton of fun. Everybody loves to catch dolphin. That's why they're rated Florida's number one offshore game fish. However, you need to remember that every single day out on the water is different, and you never know what you're going to encounter or what you're going to stumble upon. So it's really important that in order to maximize on every opportunity that comes your way, that you're well prepared with a variety of different classes of tackle. Whenever we head offshore dolphin fishing, we bring a bunch of different rods. It always starts with a really light Chaos 7-foot graphite inshore rod rated for 8 to 17 pound test. The rod is matched to a small Daiwa size 4000 spinner loaded with 10 pound diamond braid. This is the rod that we use to throw twitch baits and jigs at all of the little schoolies around the weed lines and the debris. Makes catching those small fish a lot of fun. The next rod in the arsenal is a heavy spinner. It's really important that this rod is always rigged and ready. It's a 7-foot Chaos KC 15 to 30, and it's matched to a Daiwa Isla size 7000 reel loaded with 20 pound diamond line. Again, really important that that rod is rigged with a BMC octopus hook or a jig for when those gaffers and slammers come swimming around the boat. You can quickly throw a bait out there and connect. Also, when we're trolling, one of the most important rods in our lineup is this Chaos KC 15 to 30 conventional rod, and it's matched to a Daiwa Saltis size 50 black and gold star drag reel. The reel is loaded with 20 pound diamond line, high vis, and that's really important. We fish 8 to 10 lines. Having that high vis line really makes it easy to track all of those lures and baits behind the boat. Really important in any trolling setup is that high vis line. The next step up is a 6-foot Chaos stand-up rod rated for 30 to 50 pound line. We've got this Chaos stand-up rod matched to an Alutechnos Albacore 20 loaded with 30 pound diamond line. Again, high vis, really important. This is the outfit that we use to pull our Ballyhoo Islander combos off the riggers and also some larger mole craft soft heads that we fish as teasers, and we also pick off some nice gaffers and slammers on these bigger lures. Finally, whenever we're offshore dolphin fishing or trolling, we're always pulling a planer as well. It's really important that you cover that water column. This planer rod is the one that you're gonna pick off those wahoo, you'll pick off some nice dolphin on that deep strip bait. So it's really important that you include that in your arsenal. Remember though that you've got a lot of stress being put on this outfit, a tremendous amount of strain, so it's important that this be a pretty beefy stick. This is a Chaos Tuna Buster 50 to 100 pound class rod matched to an Alutechnos 30 wide loaded with 65 pound diamond braid. A perfect setup for the planer fishing. Every single day out on the ocean is different. You never know what to expect when you're dolphin fishing. In order to maximize on every opportunity that comes your way, it's crucial that you're rigged and ready with a variety of different tackle. Guys are doing a great job down there with the spread, man. It's so important making sure that that trolling spread looks perfect, and as you can clearly see, it's paying off. And now you're going right under them both. Got to bring them both in. He's coming back out. You're over top of him. And back under.
We should name this one Flip. Come here, Flip.
Hey, that pink and white's been hot today, huh?
Been bit on pink and white, purple and black.
Every color you have in there, we've gotten
green bottom. And yellow. Nice little South Florida schoolie. Good eating. This one's probably about 22, 23 inches to the fork, perfectly legal. They gotta be 20 inches to the fork now, not 20 inches overall. Nice little fish. Dolphin fishing, baby. That's what it's all about right there.
Are you ready to get hooked up? Whoa! Florida Sport Fishing is the number one resource for the latest tips, tricks, tactics, and techniques for inshore and offshore. Each issue is jam-packed with useful articles, easy-to-follow illustrations, and award-winning photography. Only $30 for 2 years. For immediate home delivery, visit floridasportfishing.com/TV. Subscribe today and receive a free shirt and Florida Sport Fishing Hoorag.
Want more power and increased towing capacity? California Customs goes beyond the hitch. Let us transform your truck into the ultimate tow vehicle. Two and four-wheel drive, California Customs does it all. Towing accessories and load control systems, lift and leveling kits, custom wheels and tires, performance upgrades, toolboxes, and bed covers, plus all of your audio, lighting, and security needs. California Customs, let us make your vehicle what you really wanted all along.
Fortress, the world's best anchors. Stronger, faster, lighter. High-tech aluminum alloy makes Fortress anchors the easiest to handle. Precision machining and sharpening results in the fastest setting anchor. Fortress buries deep for the strongest holding power. With 8 models from 4 to 69 pounds, there's a Fortress anchor for you. Fortress, stronger, faster, lighter.
Florida Sport Fishing TV utilizes and proudly endorses Salt Life Sport Optics. Ask for them by name and see what you've been missing. Tropic Trailer, Florida's largest dealer, has the right trailer at the right price. BoatOutfitters.com. From replacement parts to hard-to-find hardware, boat owners and builders turn to BoatOutfitters.com. Dr. Dan's, from lip balm to sunblock, a complete skincare line designed for anglers and boaters. Frigid Rigid, from 35 to 300 quarts, the finest coolers and freezers on the water.
Little salad with your protein.
Yeah, a little salad. Dolphin salad. Caught fresh. Daily. Chunky chunky.
Here they come.
Woo! Woo! There they are, baby. Got them cleared already, dude.
There you go. Perfect scenario here. On the troll, right along the edge of this weed line. We've been picking fish all morning. And just had a whole pot of them come up behind the boat. Started to throw the chunks. All little schoolies, but I'll tell you, whip out the little light spinners and a ton of fun. Again, it's about being prepared. That's what dolphin fishing is. Successful dolphin fishing is about being ready for everything. You can go out one day and catch nothing but gaffers, 20 to 30 pounders. On the other hand, you can go out one day and get surrounded by schoolies. So to make the most of it, you've got to be ready for everything. We've got two on here right now. You good? You hooked up?
Yep.
Did you see him racing across?
Yeah, yeah, that was cool.
Clear as day.
I slowed down because there was a log with about a 5-pound triple tail
hanging underneath. Is that what you were yelling about up there?
Yeah. And then he came running in from nowhere.
This is a nice fish, dude.
Yep. Right in the head, Carlos. Nice.
Attaboy.
Woo!
Good job.
Yeah, baby.
Hey. Whoa. Pink and white, baby.
Hot color today.
Here you go, baby. Nice cow. Solid fish. He ate the pink and white. That's what it's all about, dolphin fishing. Nice gaff job, Carlos. Teamwork, very important when you're dolphin fishing. Everybody knows what everybody else is doing. Nice fish. Dolphin fishing, baby, get you some.
There you go.
Oh my God.
Not huge, but I'll tell you what, on a little spinner, just an absolutely ton of fun. Hey, so pretty. Of course, certainly a flipper on some bigger tackle, but on a little light 10-pound spinner, kind of hard to flip him. So we'll put him on ice.
Hey, Mike.
Screamer.
Are you having fun yet?
I am.
If you can't have fun doing this, there's something seriously wrong with you.
There is something seriously wrong, dude. If you don't like to come out and catch dolphin on light tackle, any tackle, trolling, light spinners, I mean, that's what really South Florida sport fishing is just all about.
To learn more about the tactics and techniques seen on today's show and to subscribe to Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, visit floridasportfishing.com and get hooked up.